Databases are amazing creatures. They are obedient guardians of your data. They don't weigh very much, and they survive on a simple diet of electrons. But they're not very interesting unless they are filled with data. So how do you stuff a database with numbers and dates and other information? The answer, my friends, is the insert command. Today we will learn how to insert data into a table, one row at a time and multiple rows at a time. Insert final line here before we film the video. Today we will create a database for a social network called Chitter. This lean startup will be an innovative cloud-based platform that will disrupt the social network industry by using big data and machine learning to find a synergy between influencers and thought leaders. There will be targeted ads. So how will we accomplish this? By letting people impulsively post their thoughts online. We will differentiate ourselves by adjusting the font size of each post according to the length of the post. The longer the post, the smaller the font. The database behind Chitter will consist of several tables. A Chitter user table, post table, and a follower table. The Chitter user table will have the following columns: user ID, username, encrypted password, email, and date joined. The user ID column will be an auto-generated primary key of this table. The post table will have the following columns: post ID, user ID, post text, and posted on. The post ID column will also be an auto-generated primary key. Finally, the follower table will identify who follows a particular user. It will have two columns, user ID and follower ID. These three tables should be enough for us to begin improving the world through polite, constructive online discourse. Before we start, let us see how much data we have in our user table. A clean slate. Our startup really is just starting up. Now to add data. To begin, let us insert data into the Chitter user table. To do this, use the insert into statement followed by the table name. Next, list the columns in parentheses for which you have data. Then the values keyword. And then the data in parentheses. The order of the data must match the order of the columns. This is important. Notice that we use the default keyword as the user ID. This is because our database will generate this value for us. Execute. To see that the data was successfully added, we will select the user data once more. Our data is there. And notice that the user ID was created for us. Let us add another user. This time, we will not specify values for all fields. We start with insert into and specify the table. This time, we will only insert values for the username and encrypted password. Execute. And select the rows to confirm success. Success confirmed. As before, the user ID was generated for us, and the email and date join fields are null because we did not provide values. Second user better not forget their password. Can it get any better than this? Yes. Yes, it can. Because with the insert into statement, you can add more than one row in a single query. The trick is to use commas. Fortunately, most keyboards come equipped with a comma button. Let us see how this is done. This time, we will create two posts. As before, start with the statement insert into, followed by the table name, post. I have configured the post table to automatically generate the post ID and the posted on values. All we need to do is provide the user ID and the contents of the post. The first row will be Hello World. Add a comma, and then provide the values for the next row. And execute. And confirm. And celebrate. Surprise! It is me again, and it is not the end of the video. I've negotiated more screen time with the producers. The insert into statement enables you to add one or more rows into a table. Ask yourself this, which is better? A single query inserting six rows, or six queries each inserting a single row? Or maybe multiple queries adding one plus two plus two plus one rows? Or perhaps one plus two plus one plus one plus one? We had better check. To determine which is faster, we will insert 10,000 posts into the post table in two different ways. For this demonstration, we will use Python with a Postgres database. Do not panic if you are unfamiliar with Python or Postgres. Focus on the SQL. Our objective is to see which is faster, inserting 10,000 rows separately or in a single big query. In order to talk to the database, we will use the popular PsychoPG2 module. To time our work, we need to import the time module. Let n be the number of rows we add in each batch. Next, insert queries. Each query will insert a single sentence into the post table. The other way to do this is with a single big query that inserts n rows separated by commas. To tidy up this big query, we need to remove the trailing comma and end it with a semicolon. Next, load your super secret password. Connect to the database. And create a cursor. First, we will insert 10,000 rows individually. Record the starting time. Execute the query 10,000 times. Commit them to the database. Record the stop time. And print a message with the time it took to complete all of the queries. Now for the big query. Again, record the start time. Execute the query. Commit it to the database. Record the stop time. And print the results. And finally, we demonstrate a responsible nature and close both the cursor and database connection. Now run. Inserting the data one row at a time is 20 times slower than using one big insert query with 10,000 values. This is a shining example of how you can optimize your queries. And as a sanity check, you can confirm the data is in the post table. It most definitely is. The insert into statement makes it a snap to add one or more rows to a table in a single query. But exercise caution. When inserting large volumes of data, the way you word your queries can make a big impact on how quickly they will run. The example we saw was very similar to the story of the tortoise and the hare, except it was completely different. Instead of animals, we work with SQL queries. And while slow and steady may win a race in the forest, databases are different places. Altogether,
Databases are different places.